to my channel. My name is Brittney Bundles, and today's video I'm going to be talking about different tips on putting in your 2-week notice. There are a lot of people that have been contacting me just sharing their experience, sharing their story, which I really appreciate. Whether you're contacting me because you watched a video, you have a question, you're doing consultations, drop shipping, wholesale, whatever the case may be, I really enjoy you all reaching out. So don't hesitate to reach out to me. But people have been reaching out just stating that they are quitting their jobs and that they are going to go full time with their business. And so I really think that's good. You know, I want everyone to do what works well for them. I'm not going to push anyone to quit their job or, you know, tell you that you need to quit your job because, you know, this will happen if you do. Because truly everyone has a different financial situation. And, you know, I believe in following your dreams, but I also believe in making sure that you're doing the right action steps to make sure that you have the best overall outcome. You know what I mean? So some people are ready to quit their job and go full time with their business. Some people may be ready in the next few months. Some people may be ready next year. But really, it's all about what works best for you. It's about looking at your specific financial situation, looking at, you know, how well your business is doing and the health of your business. It's about being able to project what you expect to make from your business. It's about being able to have enough savings to cover any over projection that you may have done with your business and to cover your bills and to still have money left for contingency. I mean, there's just so many things, looking at health insurance for yourself, for your children, making sure that you're in the right position as far as if you, you know, have a car that's working right now, because a lot of times if you are looking to get a loan or a lease, you know, the car dealership is going to ask for pay stubs or your, you know, 2 years of tax returns. And so if you're just going full time with your business, you may not have 2 years worth of tax returns to be able to get a new car or a mortgage on a home or anything like that. So it's really about just looking at the overall situation to see what's going to work best for you and your family and, you know, your finances. If you are there though, because there are people that are there, they're like, you know, I plan for this. I'm ready for this. I'm excited for this. And I think that's a great point to be in. I know that I was extremely excited when I decided to quit my job. And it was one job in particular that I was just excited to leave. You know, I don't know if anyone can relate, but I was truly excited to leave. You know, I was just eager. Every day before I put in my 2-week notice, I would start putting things, you know, packing my things up, you know. So if I, you know, sometimes you decorate your desk and you have a whole bunch of things on there, you can pretty much tell when I was about to leave. I mean, you can't, but you could, because I'm just packing up different things and people would ask, what are you doing? Oh, I'm just cleaning out my desk. And I was cleaning out my desk. They thought that I was maybe cleaning it out to make space for more things. And I knew I'm cleaning it out to actually leave and give you all your space back. So I'm just going to go over some tips that really helped me with being able to transition from different jobs. I mean, even if you're not looking at being 100% full-time with your business, you may be in a position where you're like, hey, I know that I'm at a job right now, but I do not see myself being in this job a year from now, or as soon as another opportunity presents itself, I'm gone. And so there's the right way to do everything. As always, in all of my videos, I love to say, do what works best for you. You know, take any advice that's going to help your situation and benefit you, and leave any advice that you feel like does not apply to you or may not be beneficial to you. So if you are interested, be sure to give the video a big thumbs up. Please make sure that you are subscribed, and let's get right into the video. So the first tip that I want to get into is, when you put in your 2-week notice, please be prepared to possibly be let go sooner than your 2 weeks. I've learned that quick, you know, early on, just working in different companies, I'm very observant. And so I like to sit back and see the culture of the business. I like to see how things work, you know, in the interview process. It's great. You know, it's a time for the employer to interview you, but it's also a time for you to interview the employer. And a lot of times you don't really see or understand the full idea or picture of what you're getting yourself into until you actually start working, which is normal. You know, you really don't understand everything that's going to happen until you actually get in the motion and you get at that job. And so I would get, you know, at my job, and I would sit around and I would look at different things that was happening and, you know, just different circumstances. Sometimes if you're in the break room, you hear a lot of information, and I would just sit back and observe. And I learned that a lot of jobs don't keep you when you put in your 2-week notice. There was a job that I worked at where they didn't even accept 2-week notices. I mean, I don't want to say they didn't accept them, but if you put in your 2-week notice, then they set up an expectation already that they were going to let you go. I don't know if that was, I think that was legal. I was going to say, I don't know if it was legal or not, but yeah, they, you know, we had an expectation at that company that if you put in your 2-week notice, you are going to be, you know, have to leave that day. And there's other companies where it was kind of like up in the air. They may keep you for a week or they may keep you for a few days, but typically, you know, I've rarely seen jobs where you put in your 2-week notice and you stay the full week or full 2 weeks. It's happened, but I just wanted, you know, to put that out there, that my first, I guess, tip or point of advice that I wanted to give out is if you are going to put in your two-week notice, please be prepared to leave that day or leave soon. Some of the things that I would do to prepare myself would be to, like I mentioned a little bit ago, I would start packing some things up. I never really want to leave a place and have to carry so many boxes across parking lots and, you know, people are stopping you. What happened? Where are you going? Where are you? You know what I mean? So I don't know if it's just me, but I didn't like that. I don't really like bringing a lot of attention to what's going on with me. And, you know, the people that I work with, that I was close with, they already would know what was happening. And if they didn't know, then I would be able to, you know, I would call them or text them or let them know. But I didn't want it to be like a whole bigger deal. So, and I never wanted to just carry heavy boxes either. So I would just make sure that I packed light. You know, if I came into work, I would make sure that I'm not bringing a lot of things there, that, you know, when I leave work, I'm taking down some pictures. I wouldn't take them down all at once so that it looks obvious, but little by little, I'm kind of taking down things. And when it's time to go, I literally could just go ahead, grab a few things and walk out. Now, another thing that I do want to advise on if you are planning on putting in your two-week notice, and just trying to read my notes here, is make sure that you have an income source and also savings saved up. Now, everyone feels comfortable with a different amount of savings in their account before they decide to quit or put in their two-week notice. But for me, I have children, like I mentioned in a lot of videos. And so I have to move according to what's going to work best for my family. So I know that, okay, even if I want to quit today, I have to look at everything. Do I have a way to generate income, you know, back into my household? Do I have a savings so that even if the way that I'm expecting to be able to generate income doesn't work, what am I going to do with my 401 and my, you know, IRA? Am I going to roll those over to my next job? Am I able to roll them over? What's the balance looking like? What are the penalties if I need to withdraw extra money? You know, so you want to kind of look at that and kind of, you know, make sure that you have backup plans on top of backup plans on top of backup plans, because, you know, you never know what's going to happen. You may get a job immediately. You know, sometimes people will actually wait to put in their two-week notice until they have another job secured. But that's if you're looking to go to another employer. If you are looking at continuing your business full-time and not looking at another job, then you want to make sure that you have that set up in line too. The difference between the two is really, you know, with going to another job, you have more of a, you know, okay, this is what you're going to get paid. You know what I mean? These are what your checks are going to be, unless you're going to like a sales position where it's only commission. But when you're looking at a sales position job or only commission or your business, nothing is really guaranteed as far as how much you're going to make. I mean, there's not an agreement that you can just say, okay, hey, you know, business, pay me this amount of month, each month, you know, unless your business is already there. But even if it's already there, you never know. I mean, there's always a risk. You know what I mean? There's a chance in business that you may not do as well as you projected for yourself. So making sure that you have a savings, making sure that you have an income source, and making sure that you are familiar with your retirement accounts, just in case you have to pull from your accounts, is going to be beneficial. No, I do not recommend pulling from your accounts because you are going to have penalties if you're under a certain age. I mean, it's not worth it. So you definitely should, and you want to save it up for retirement anyways. So I'm not saying do that, you know, I'm just saying you want to make sure that you're looking at all of your options and you want to know where you stand, where the chips fall before you go ahead and put in the two-week notice. Another thing that I would do and that I do if I'm looking at putting in a two-week notice is I research like insurance, like when does my insurance stop? So if I put in my two-week notice, is it stopping that day? Some companies are set up different where it's like, hey, you've paid your premium up until this month, or you paid for your insurance plan up until this month. So even if you put in your two-week notice here, your insurance goes until this date. So I kind of make sure that's done. And then also I make mental notes of when I'm planning on putting in a two-week notice. So if I know that I need dental work done, I'll try to go ahead and get that scheduled before I put in my two-week notice, just me. If I know that my children need dental work and I have a really, really good insurance policy with this you know, business or with this company, I'm gonna try to get them in. Not saying that you can't get dental work done after you leave, because you are going to need to get other insurance options. I'm just saying if it's going to save you more money to get the work done under this, you know, employer's insurance policy that you're paying for out of your check or that you paid for up front, I would go ahead and get those things knocked out. And then also be looking for different ways to continue the insurance plan after you leave. Typically, once you put in your two-week notice, then your human resources department, they're going to start sending you information about how to do that, how to continue with your insurance plan if there's an option, how to look at different insurance options and things like that. So you just want to make sure that you're looking at the whole picture I think a lot of times when people do quit, they don't really think about those kind of things. You don't really think about insurance. You don't really think about your retirement accounts. You don't really think about, just making sure everything's there. A lot of times we can find ourselves having a one-track mind and a one-track vision. It's just like, okay, my business is making some money, so I'm gonna quit, you know? But there's really a lot more information and detail that we wanna make sure that we're looking at and evaluating before we make that decision. Now, another thing that I do is if I'm putting in a 2-week notice, different jobs are different, but I like to print out a copy of the 2-week notice and actually sign and date it. I also like to email, my manager, and I like to CC the HR department. To me, it's just covering my bases. It's just letting everyone know that I did put in my 2-week notice. So whether, you know, I just fear for me putting in a 2-week notice and my manager saying, well, I didn't get it. Well, I don't know. It was in my desk with all these other papers. How do I, you know what I mean? So I just like to make sure that I'm covering my bases. So I print out a copy, which I, you know, sign and date, put it on their desk. I go ahead and email them. And I also CC the human resources department. That way everyone has the information. So even if your manager is saying that they didn't receive a 2-week notice and you're just quitting or whatever the case may be, quitting on the spot, then you still have proof, you know, yeah, I did send this over, and I actually copy the human resources department as well. So that's what I do. I don't like the 2-week notice to be really, really long. I know my last 2-week notice that I put in, it was a long time ago, so I don't know exactly word for word what I put in there, but I know that the first 2-week notice that I was writing, it was like felt with so much emotion because there were some things that happened at the job that really hurt my feelings, and I really felt unappreciated, and I felt like my services and my contributions to the business, I felt like they weren't being seen. I felt like they were being just taken for granted, and I knew that I wasn't being appreciated there. And I brought it up a few times, and so when I wrote my first 2-week notice, I found that it was just packed with so much, like, I don't want to say anger, but with so much emotion. And I went back and I had to reread it and think on it a few days. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to take this out and I'm literally going to get to just the meat of, you know, this is my 2-week notice. So that's what I did. I wrote a 2-week notice thanking them for the opportunity because ultimately, I appreciate any job that I've ever worked for. I mean, whether I liked the job or not, it really helped me learn more. I mean, I can't say that there's ever been a job that I've ever worked at that I didn't learn something from, whether I learned what not to do or I learned about different cultures and different environments in the workforce. I learned more about, inclusion. I learned more about, just working with people. I learned more sales skills. I learned so much from every job that I've ever had. So I wanted to still incorporate that. I didn't want to seem like I was bitter, and I really got to the meats of it. So instead of sending like a 3-page, 2-week notice, I narrowed that down to like maybe a paragraph. If that, I think it was like maybe 4 sentences. So I just wanted to put that out there. You're free to do whatever you want. But for me, for my 2-week notice, I went back and I just kind of got to the meat of it. And that was that. Like I mentioned, number 3 was start packing up your belongings beforehand so that you don't have to carry out all of your belongings in this big box. Because I don't know, it's like since I was a child, you'll watch movies or people would leave or get fired or quit, and they'll have like all these big, this huge box to carry out. And it was kind of like the box of shame. And I don't know, it wasn't even that I was necessarily shamed for quitting. I just didn't want to carry a huge box. And so I just started packing little things periodically. Like every day I would pack a couple things up. We also went over, check out your 401 and IRA withdrawal options, just in case. I don't recommend using them, but you want to know where you stand just in case. And then what else did I put? Keep letters short and concise and leave on a good note despite your experiences. So I've touched that too. It takes a lot to be the bigger person and to leave on a good note, but it's going to work best in the end. You know, sometimes people would be like, you know, I'm going to quit and I'm going to give them a piece of my mind. And you definitely can, but there's a way to do it. And you just don't want you leaving to stop or block any other opportunities in the future because of how you left one job. So that's really what I try to do. And then also what I would do as well, just from, you know, if I'm just doing girl talk to you, I would just say, don't tell a lot of people that you work with, or you may not even want to tell anyone that you work with that you're planning on putting in a 2-week notice until, you know, you actually do it. And even, you know, I personally didn't tell anyone that I was putting in a 2-week notice. I just, when I left, I had a few friends that I worked with that I text and let them know I wasn't coming back. And, you know, this is what I'm doing and, you know, things like that. But I didn't make a big deal out of it. The reason that I didn't tell people that I was working with is because, you know, in offices or in salons, I've worked in offices, salons, you know, just whatever, wherever you work. And from my experience, word really spreads like wildfire. And not saying that you have to keep it a secret, but I just feel like if the information gets in the wrong hands, like such and such is planning on quitting, you know, you may have had a change of heart the next day, or you may change your mind the next week. It may not even be on that anymore. You may say, you know what, I looked at everything and I decided that I am going to stay here for a little bit longer. And by that time, your manager has already heard that you're looking at quitting. So they're, you know, looking at people to replace you. And, you know, your job could be, you could be terminated from your position either way by letting someone else know what you're planning on doing. So for me, one thing that you may have gotten from this video is that I like to make sure that I'm double checking everything and that I'm thinking ahead a few steps. So yeah, that's what I do if I'm looking at putting in a 2-week notice. So anyone that is considering quitting their job, or they're like, you know what, I know I'm about to quit my job, I just don't know what to do, how to do it, these are some things that I would consider doing, and you know, go for it. So I really hope that this video helped, just kind of sharing some of my experiences with putting in 2-week notices. Ultimately, you know, I want to say congratulations to everyone that is deciding to quit their job and focus full time on their business. I also want to say congratulations for those that are deciding to continue their job and still work on their business. Ultimately, you know, you can do both. You can be an entrepreneur. You can still work a 9-to-5. You can do, you know, you can wear many, many hats. Ultimately, just find what works best for you. And I know it's very tempting to go ahead and quit when your business starts generating orders. But before you do that, there's a right way to do everything. So just make sure that you're looking at everything before you go ahead and jump. Yes, I believe in faith. Yes, I have faith. Yes, I believe in going after your dreams. You all know I do. I talk about that all the time. But I also believe in doing it the right way. And, you know, when you ask what's the right way, it ultimately boils down to what's going to work best for your life and your situation. So I hope this video helped. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.